what's up guys, Zach here. Hope you're doing well today. Welcome to this video. Today we're gonna discuss how to handle appropriately an inbound lead. Okay, what's an inbound lead? Why does it matter? And what do we do with them once they come to our world, right? Because they don't always have their money out. Every once in a while, they're calling to determine, you know, who you really are, what this business really is, and what do I really get for my money, right? Now, I'll tell you this. There's two kinds of leads. Well, there's three, I guess, but there's two kinds I like. Number one, somebody who calls on the phone. If that person calls on the phone, they're very, very qualified. They need something soon. Number two, someone who fills out one of our questionnaires on the on a form on our website. Typically, they spend some time typing it up. They have some information. They need more information from you. They want to know something. They want to get a project started soon. And number three, somebody who emails you just asking for information, right? These are all inbound leads, okay? So the very best thing you can do when someone's inbound is to position yourself as an authoritative, kind service provider who wants to provide a service and serve that person, okay? So when somebody calls you, and whether you call them back or whether you are answering the phone right then and there, the first thing you need to do when they're inbound is be kind, right? Hey, how are you doing? Like, ask about them. Ask, be human, right? Ask who they are. Yeah, what's your name? What's your project look like? And they'll tell you about it. After you have the information, you need to always ask more questions because a lot of times folks will just not really know what to ask. Let's say someone says, well, I want a virtual tour. I'm like, okay, well, what's the location? What's the property look like? Yeah, that's a good first question, right? And they'll say, oh, well, it's this, or oh, well, it's that. Oh, they could say something like, oh, well, it's an apartment complex on the west side of town. I'm like, okay, cool. You need to ask more questions, because the more questions you ask, the more qualified you seem as a contractor or service provider. So for example, if it's an apartment complex, you could say, okay, cool. So here's how we charge. I'm going to ask a couple questions. How many amenities do you want me to shoot, and how many floor plans are there? So now I've asked a very specific question about their niche, right? This comes with knowledge. You have to know these things up front in order to be able to ask those questions. When you do that, you automatically build rapport and gain trust from your prospect, right? They'll tell you, oh, well, we got four amenities and we have, you know, three floor plans, but I probably just want to shoot one or two floor plans. And I'll say, okay, cool. So, and you could have tiered pricing based on those things. And you can even know right then and there what you're going to charge them. And you're going to change no matter what. Doesn't matter. Still important to ask one more question. You know, like, okay, well, so are you the property manager? You know, who are you in the transaction? You know, or that's kind of a thing I probably wouldn't say. I'd probably say, so what's your role? And like, are you the owner? Yeah, that's okay to ask that question. And say, no, I'm not the product manager. I say, oh, okay. So, now you're going to ask, are you just getting quotes, or are you like going to be the one making the choice? Right. So you need to know that. You need to qualify them on the phone. It's really important, because that's how you know what else to ask, what to say. And if they say, oh, well, I make the choice, I have a certain budget. It's like, oh, okay, what's your budget? You need to find out what that is. And they're like, oh, well, you know, tell me, what do you charge? I said, well, this is why you asked that question. And I like that question, but it's important. You need to say something like this. You need to say, well, here's the reason why. I know that certain allocated amounts of money are budgeted for this kind of project. Sometimes my quote may be over that, because we're the best in the whole city. But if I'm close, or if I can meet that budget, I would rather do the work than miss it, because I typically quote a certain amount, right? So I guess what I'm saying is, work with me here. We would kind of have the partnership approach. And if my $600 quote is 100 bucks off, let me know. I can lower it to 500, but I'm gonna need, like, you know, a referral or something. You know, so now you're in negotiation mode, right? So that's where you wanna be. You wanna be a partnership. So when an inbound lead comes in, your pricing can be higher. And also too, you have a lot of like good positioning, right? It's a good place to be. Doesn't mean you're going to like necessarily always close a deal. You may get an inbound lead who's a waste of your time. There's plenty of inbound leads who are a waste of your time. But if people, I kind of walked you through an example, if you ask enough questions, you can get to the money question with a lot of authority, right? That's really important. And also too, you want to take an apartment type approach. You don't want to just be blasting out quotes and like just never talk to anybody on the phone. This is really important. So if someone comes in via the second thing I mentioned, which was the web form, you want to call them. Say, hey, listen, I got your information. How are you? Now they go from a very impersonal encounter to a personal one. That's a much better place to be, and they're still an inbound prospect, right? So you have a little bit of information, maybe some whatever they typed into the web form, and now you can start discussing the project. That's what you want to do. And number three was email. You can always reply to the email or say, hey, tell me more about the project. If the person is a bad lead, they don't want to put in the work to get the to actually go get to the end of the day anyway. So it's easy to filter these folks out, right? Someone who wants best price, I mean, if you get them on the phone, you know, hey, listen, I need the best price always, but I promise you, you're gonna love it. Or you can do like, with inbound things, and you also have the kind of stuff you can do. And you have less leverage when you're doing outbound. But we can discuss outbound later, but basically you don't have to throw in a lot of negotiation things on price. You don't want to negotiate price. You want to make the transaction as high as you can. At the same time, you don't want to get greedy. You need to understand your market, understand your niche, and be somewhere in the middle. And then in the future, as you kind of scale, you can lower a little bit if you have to, just to make those things efficient, figure out what's the best price from there. But yeah, that's kind of how you handle inbound lead. Always be kind, ask lots of questions, and make sure you work in a partnership type approach when it comes to pricing, right? And then in the future, you train your inbound people, inbound salespeople to be able to talk this way, so they know what to do with inbound leads. Well, that's it for now for this video. Thanks for watching. Hope inbound leads come to you soon and you're closing down quick. I'll see you soon.